brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Qur'an. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Qur'an are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span. Sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is a truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leaves astray, none can show him guidance. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah alone, and I bear witness that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his last messenger. My dear viewers, welcome to another live edition of Correct Your Citation. And I would like to welcome our studio guests, Sheikh Abdurrahman, Ahmed Muhammad, and Ahmed Sharqawi. Thank you for joining us with another beautiful live edition of our program, Correct Your Citation. Today, inshallah, we'll begin a new chapter, Surat Ghafir, or the Forgiving One, the Almighty Ghafir. And it is chapter number 40, and it is the first in the list of the seven chapters which are known as Al-Hawamim. Some of the scholars dislike to call them Hawamim, rather they like to call them Al-Hamim. We'll talk about that inshallah once we come to explain the beautiful surah of Surah Ghafir, this Makki surah. But without any further ado, I'd like to hear a beautiful recitation of Surah Ghafir from the beginning through ayah number 9 from our brother Abdurrahman. Please go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافل الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم يسبحون بحمد ربهم بِهِمْ وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا فَاغْفِرْ لِلَّذِينَ تَابُوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
اللهم اجعلنا منهم. Thank you so much. May Allah bless you. It was beautiful, mashallah. Beautiful. 9 verses of Surah Ghafir, chapter number 40. A Mecca Surah. It was revealed in the Meccan era. It was revealed in Mecca before the migration. So you can imagine that the main theme will be addressing the concept of belief, aqidah, monotheism, and so on. It will be addressing the angels. It will be addressing the struggle of the believers versus their opponents of the disbelievers, whether the Meccan pagans or those who were before them, such as the struggle of Prophet Moses with the Pharaoh and his host, the struggle of the prophets before Musa alayhi salam, Nuh, Salih, Thamud, and so on, as you will appear in the following ayat, inshallah. And also I'd like to tell you, brothers and sisters, Surah Ghafir has another name. You know, when you open the Qur'an, and some like to call it Surah Al-Mu'min. Well, I know that there is Surah Al-Mu'minun. And Al-Mu'minun is plural of Mu'min. So we have Surah Al-Mu'minun, correct? That precedes Al-Anbiya. But what is Al-Mu'min? Al-Mu'min is a believer. Al-Mu'minun, the believers. But it's stated in the Quran, Surah Ghafir, because of the third ayah, Ghafir is them. But Surah Ghafir is also known as Surah Al-Mu'min because in ayah number 28, the Almighty Allah will tell us about an incident. وَقَالَ رَجُلٌ مُؤْمِنٌ مِنْ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ. Okay, that's an interesting story. We'll learn about Al-Mu'min, the believing person who was concealing his identity during the time of the Pharaoh and Moses' struggle with the Pharaoh and his host. So keep that in mind, inshallah, and we'll come across this ayah number 28, chapter number 40, Surah Ghafir or Surah
Al-Mu'min.
Perfect. This surah consists of 85 ayahs. As you know, that I like to call it an ayah, and you know, rarely I like to use the term verse because the ayat of the Quran are not just verses. They are miracles. They are of miraculous nature. Their miraculous nature is not over by the time of the death of the Prophet ﷺ. It is renewed. Every day we find something new by the grace of Allah. Since the entire Quran is the everlasting miracle. I also say that Surah Ghafir is one of 7 surahs or chapters, and it is the first in the list of 7 chapters which are known as Al-Hamim. Ibn Sirin, may Allah have mercy on him, said, I don't like to call it Al-Hawamim. You know, it's like a way of pluralizing Hamim, the beginning. They are called Al-Hamim, or the chapters, the surahs, or the family of the surahs which begin with Hamim. Other scholars, they didn't mind calling them Al-Hawamim for easiness, so that the youth, the children, when they memorize the Quran, they know that those seven chapters which begin with Ghafir, followed by Fussilat, then Ash-Shura, Al-Zukhruf, Al-Dukhan, Al-Jathiyah, and Al-Ahqaf. Wait a minute, we did study many of these chapters before, correct? So, Surah Ghafir, in order, is the first of those seven Al-Hamim surahs. And since every time we speak about Hamim or Alif Lam Mim, we speak about the differences of opinion of the scholars concerning those letters, because we pronounce them as letters, not as words. Yeah. Sah? Yeah. We don't say Alam. Yeah. Each one of those letters has a Mad letter. So there is Ha, and there is Mad Tabi'i, and there is Mim. Right? Alif Lam Mim, Alif Lam Mim, 6 and 6.
Yes.
Correct? So we don't pronounce them as Alam, such as in the beginning of Surah Al-Sharh, Alam Nashrah, or Surah Al-Fil, Alam Tara Kaifa Fa'ala, Alam. The spelling is the same, but the reading, the pronunciation is entirely different. That is Mad letters. We read them as separate letters. So since we discussed repeatedly the meaning of those letters, why don't we just jump into conclusion and go to the next ayah? If any of the viewers haven't attended previously when we spoke about Hamim or those letters, you can check out on the YouTube or online any of the previous videos for time's sake. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم. This book is a Tanzeel, the revelation from Allah. Al-Aziz is one of Allah's names, which is the Almighty. Al-Hakim, another beautiful name, which is Al-Hakim, full of Al-Alim, which is the All-Knowing. Tanzeel al-Kitabi min Allah al-Aziz al-Alim. Al-Aziz is one of Allah's names, is not it. It's also that He's the source of Izzah. Izzah, يعني mighty, power, honor and majesty. And we find in Surah Ali Imran, Allah the Almighty says that He is the one who gives Izzah to whomever He wills. And He takes it away from ever He wills. Didn't He say in Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 26, chapter number 3, تُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ اللَّهُمْ قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء. So now, تعز من تشاء, only you, the Almighty Allah, He give mighty and honor to whomever you will. وتذل من تشاء. What is the opposite of عزة? ذلة. And ذلة means disgrace and humiliation. Yeah, Abdul Rahman, in Surah Al-Munafiqun, when this guy said, لَإِن رَجَعْنَا إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ لَيُخْرِجَنَّ الْأَعَزُّ مِنْهَا الْأَذَلُ. Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, how did Allah the Almighty reply to him? وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَكِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. So the mighty, the honor, and the power belong only to Allah and accordingly to His messenger who's conveying His message, and to those who follow Him and to the believers. And while disgrace is upon the disbelievers and those who challenge and oppose the messenger of Allah or any of the messengers of Allah or any of the ayat of Allah, keep that in mind, please. So this book is a revelation of the Almighty, the All-Knowing. And if this is the case, then you would never expect to find any errors or drawbacks or a need for an addition or correction in the book. لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنزيل من
حكيم.
Okay, so now once تنزيل من حكيم حميد, This book is a revelation of Hakim, all wise, Hamid, worthy of praise, all worthy of praise. And here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Tanzeelul Kitab from Allah, the Almighty, the All-Knowing. So the case is closed. You will never, ever find any error, whether in the past, the present, or the future, in the book of Allah. And no one would ever be able to bring any ayah similar to the ayat of the Qur'an. قُلْ إِنْ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Not even if all mankind and all jinnkind happen to see each other and have council meetings, all the experts, in order to make up anything similar or to come up with a book similar to the Qur'an, no. It will never happen. غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول. Among Allah's names is Al-Ghafur and Al-Rahim and At-Tawwab. Al-Ghafur is the one who forgives. He covers up the sins so that they won't show. At-Tawwab, Tawwab al-Rahim, he is the one who frequently accepts the repentance. No matter how many times you sin, as long as you repent, he will accept it. You sin, you repent, he will accept it. Doesn't he get bored? Doesn't he get tired? Doesn't he get offended that because no matter how many times you repent, you go back to the sin? As a matter of fact, it is on the contrary. So let's see what the ayah says. غَافِرِ الذَّنْبِ. Allah is a forgiver of sin, yani all sins. قَابِلِ التَّوْبِ. He is the acceptor of At-tawb, any repentance, as long as it happens before death, or before experiencing death agonies, or before the sun rises from the west. Because if it happens during any of these critical times, it's of no use. Somebody got hit by a bus or in a car collision, and now he's seeing the angels of death extracting the soul, says, I repent, I'm going to pray. Now recognize Allah, too late. As a matter of fact, the Quran says, وَإِن مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لَيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ. And the Mufassirin said in this ayah that there is not a single person, whether a Jew or a Christian, but he would definitely believe in the truth and would recognize that Jesus is not a son of God, rather he is a messenger of Allah. Muhammad is a messenger of Allah. Moses is a messenger of Allah. Allah is the only one who is worthy of worship. قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ. Right before his death. But it will be too late. It will be too late. So in this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he will accept the repentance. At-tawwab is an extensive form, which means no matter how many times you repent, he will still accept the repentance. In the hadith, the Almighty Allah says, so it's a sacred hadith. أَذْنَبَ عَبْدٌ ذَنْبًا. Somebody have committed a sin. And he said, oh Allah, forgive me. And he repented. So Allah said, my servant have committed a sin. And he recognized that there is a Lord. He has got a God who may punish for the sin or forgive the sin. And he sought my forgiveness. I grant you forgiveness, O my servant. And the same servant commits the sin again. And says, oh my God, forgive me. I repent. So the Almighty Allah says, أَذْنَبَ عَبْدِي ذَنْبًا. Again, the same servant. So Allah the Almighty will say, I forgive you. And that will happen over and over and over and over until Allah the Almighty will say, as long as you recognize that you have a Lord who may punish for the sin and may forgive for it, do as you wish, I will forgive you all your sins. Some people, intellectual people, true believers, people with good hearts, they look at this hadith as, this is a sign of mercy, I should be shy of disobeying Allah. I should be embarrassed after all that mercy to displease him. On the other hand, you'll find people who say, oh, okay, well, this is what God says. So do as you wish, he's forgiven. Why don't you pray? He's forgiven. Why do you drink? He's forgiven. Why do you steal? Isn't he forgiven? Yeah, I see people who say that. We all meet people who don't pray and they say, because he's Ghafoor al-Rahim. Don't worry, he will take care of us. But why don't you just read the ayah to the end? I heard the Shaykh saying, غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب. And normally the Quran, when it comes to mercy, forgiveness and punishment or justice, it keeps balance. That is not mentioned by itself. Like in Surat Ibrahim, نبي عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. Inform my servants, O Muhammad, peace be upon him, that I am indeed الغفور الرحيم, the oft forgiving, the most merciful. But wait a minute, it's not over yet. ونبئهم. And also inform them that my torment is a painful one. So what does it mean? Allah wants us to live in this life with the wings of a bird to keep balance between hope and fear. Some people would do anything that Allah wants them to do and will abstain from anything even though they desire it simply because Allah says so. They love Him. They hope for His mercy. But there are other category of people who wallahi would not quit what is wrong and would not do what is right unless if there is a threat. If you don't do that, you will be punished. And if you indulge in this sin, you will be punished. So that's why Allah the Almighty delivers both. If you're frightened and you don't want to hear the punishment and alhamdulillah you're a good person, so what suits you is ar-raja. If you're a person whom you feel that your whim and desire is overwhelming, then what suits you is al-khawf. At the time of death, it is better to give precedence to araja, hope. أنا عند ظن عبدي بي, I am exactly as my servant expects from me. The Tawl means that Allah the Almighty is the bestower of all favors. He is full of bounties. لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. There is none but Him to be worshipped. Unto Him is the final return. Subhanallah, when you think about it, and that you're living in this life under His supervision and under His control, He's just given you the free choice concerning your actions, whether to do good or to choose to do bad. But by the end, unto Him is ilayhi al-masir. We say in our supplication when we go to sleep, and we teach our kids and we tell them the meaning of this supplication. You put your right hand before your right cheek, you lie down on your right side, say, Smik Allahumma amutu aw ahya. Ahya, yani I come back to life. So when you wake up, you say, Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana, but wa ilayhi nushur. Correct? Yeah, we came back to life. Thanks to Allah who brought us back to life after He has caused us to die. And unto Him will be an-nushur again. So al-masir is unto Him. Resurrection is unto Him. Return is unto Him. ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد. Many Muslims ask this most frequently asked question nowadays, which is, you see the condition of the Muslim Ummah, how weak, oppressed, and persecuted. Look at Muslims in China, look at Muslims in Russia, look at Muslims here and there, while you see the non-Muslims enjoying their lives and prospering. So Allah the Almighty tells us, look at this, non-disputes concerning the ayat of Allah, the ayat applied to the ayat, the verses of the Quran, or the proofs or evidences, or messages that was revealed to the messengers. No one argues concerning the ayat of Allah except the non-believers, those who disbelieve. فَلَا يَغْرُرْكَ تَقَلُّبُهُمْ فِي الْبِلَادِ. So let not their ability of going about here and there through the land deceive you, O Muhammad, and all the believers. This is all temporary. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. When you see the Almighty Allah is giving abundance, plenty of rizq and success to somebody who doesn't believe in Him, this is not a sign of success. That is called withdrawal. So if he realizes that this is from Allah and he appreciates that, he's successful, otherwise he's ruined. And Allah tells us that those, only those who argue concerning the oneness of Allah, the proofs, whether in the universal book, the signs that we see around us, or in the revealed book, none but the disbelievers. Sometimes we have Orientalists. The term refers to those who study Islam for the sole purpose of finding drawbacks in order to spread misconceptions and bad thoughts about Islam to attack Islam and Muslims. Many of those Orientalists, Nashawati, end up accepting Islam. Many of our contemporary time, of those who have nothing to do in life but to shame and disgrace Islam and Muslims, ended up accepting Islam. The director and the producer of the movie Fitna, Arnold Van Dorn. To be honest with you, brothers and sisters, I never ever dreamt one day that we'd become friends. Yes, we're friends. We're very close friends. How would this happen? This is the guy who did the blasphemy and wanted to, you know, disgrace Prophet Muhammad and Islam and Muslims. But look at him now. He's a da'iyah. He's a caller to Islam. He's a preacher. How? Through his studies, he realized that this is the truth, and this is rather the ultimate truth. A couple days ago, Joram Van Caliburn, another very active, far-right politician, he's like, you know, one of those who hated Islam most. He just accepted Islam a couple of days ago. Why? While he was in the process of مَا يُجَادِلُ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, he was in that category. Then he said, while I was writing a book bashing Islam and Muslims, halfway through, I came to realize that that is the truth. And this is how he ended up accepting Islam. How? Through realizing that he was wrong, I was wrong. And that happens a lot, brothers and sisters. So before we wrap it up, I would like to say that it happened once, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. And Umar ibn Khattab was a very powerful man. And when he became the Khalifa, he was like a man of justice. Somebody came to him and said, I committed a big, big sin. What did he say? He read, غافر الذنب وقابل التوب. So the guy realized that that's him who forgives. I should ask from Allah directly. There was a man, a prestigious man from Asham, who used to attend the halqa and the gathering of Umar ibn Khattab. Then he disappeared. He inquired about him. They said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, he relapsed. Now he has become alcoholic. He drinks. He doesn't want to come anymore. So he wrote him a letter from Umar ibn Khattab, radiallahu anhu, after he said, أَحْمَدُ اللَّهَ إِلَيْكَ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ غَافِرُ الذَّنْبِ قَابِلُ التَّوْبِ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ ذِي الطَّوْلِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ إِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرِ. The message which we just explained. He just quoted in a message the first couple of verses of Surat Ghafir. So the guy cried and he said, SubhanAllah, Allah is telling me that he is forgiven. He accepts the tawbah. And he is warning me that he is shadeed, severe in torment and punishment. So he quit and he repented and he never returned back to drinking. So when this happened and the good news came to Umar al-Khattab, he said, similarly, when you see somebody have relapsed, remind him with those ayat. We're going to take a short break, brothers and sisters. But inshallah, we'll be back in a couple of minutes to open the phone lines for the recitation of those beautiful ayat. Please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
That group of category is one of the seven people who will be under the shade when there is no shade but Allah's shade on the Day of Judgment.
Colors of Arabic language, explain the word, the meaning of the word haya. They said it's the fear of something that's shameful.
At the same time you try to solve your problems, then you will see the results. And the advantage is sticking to the Sunnah. When you stick to the sunnah, that's when you see the advantage. But could you elaborate more? What do you mean, sticking to the sunnah?
It made a lot of, you know, major sense, because the problem is that they convince you, they try to convince you by saying, Wallahi is the best, you know, Wallahi it is the best, you won't find anything like it, you know? So you're going from a sin to another sin, to a greater sin.
Man, it's been over 1 hour, I'm waiting for you.
Okay, bro, it's not a big deal.
At least you should have called.
Oh, not again. Don't get too serious.
عباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما.
So let's get inspired. Let's get motivated to worship Allah in the best way. Let's get motivated not only to worship Allah in the best way, but to race to do good deeds. Join us in this program, Islamic Motivation, by your brother, Rayyan Arab, exclusively on Within TV.
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا.
We all know that a person's iman increases and decreases, and the best way to increase your iman is through the Quran.
To contemplate, to reflect, to ponder over the verses of the Quran.
أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا.
In this program, we will listen to the Quran first, and that should soften our hearts. And then once we get to know the meanings and contemplate over these meanings, then we can change by the will of Allah subhanahu
wa ta'ala. ولا يأتونك بمثل إلا جئناك بالحق وأحسن تفسيرا.
Join us on Quran Circle 2 and increase your iman.
I spend my life running away from you. Now I have nowhere to turn except to you.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created man. And man has outer features as well as inner features. One of the most important of his inner features is his heart. So what is the heart? What is meant by this heart that is in our bodies? And what is the health of the heart? And what is the disease of the heart? There are many diseases of the heart, and there are many actions of the heart, things that make it healthy. So what are these diseases? What are these actions? Come and join us on Huda TV in this program of ours, Heart Therapy.
So drink my heart, please, wash the filth away. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray. Don't leave me drowning here, alone and astray.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. My dear viewers, let me remind you with our phone numbers. If you're interested to give us a call, we'll be reciting today from the beginning of Surah Ghafir through ayah number 9. Surah Ghafir is chapter number 40, page number 467. Phone numbers area code 002, then 0238-555-132. Alternatively, area code 002, then 01005469323. WhatsApp numbers area code 001-361-489-1503. Last WhatsApp number, area code 001-347-80625. We're live on the Facebook as well. And without any further ado, we're going to begin with our studio guest, Ahmed Abdurrahman. Am I correct? Go ahead and recite. Okay, I will take this call first. Brother Abdul Rahim from Kuwait. Assalamu alaikum and welcome to the program. Abdul Rahim, can you hear me?
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to the program. Go ahead and recite from the beginning of Surah Ghafir, please. Hameem.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب
عبد الرحيم.
وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا.
Can you hear me? عبد الرحيم. Can you hear me? السلام عليكم. Can you hear me? Okay, go ahead and continue if you can hear me. We'll talk after you finish, inshallah. Continue. وكذلك حقت. Okay, we may have lost them. Beautiful citation, of course, mashallah. There is a very fine trick when it comes to the letter ra, especially if it falls by the end of the word where you stop at it. So the ra is either with Fatha, Zabar, Kasra, Zair, or Dhamma, Pesh. So, if any of these vowels come, would determine the fate of how to pronounce the Ra. So, always Ra with Fatha or with Dhamma is fattened. That's why, what is your name? Abdul Rahim. Ra, Ra. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Because the Ra has Fatha. But once the Ra has Kasra, automatically the Ra will be thinned. Min sharril waswasil khannas. Sharri, sharri. With the tip of your tongue. Okay? Similarly, if the Ra, we know the vowels are four, not only Fatha, Dhamma, and Kasra, these are called harakat, but there is also sukun. What if the ra' has sakin, such as when you stop at it, masir, you stopped. So how would I know to pronounce the ra'? Look, the ra' originally has dhamma. So aromatically you say this is fattened, but only if you connect it. Like you say, إِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ مَا يُجَادِلُ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْمَصِيرُ مَا يُجَادِلُ because you connected it. If I stop at it, I change any vowel into non-vowel. into sukoon. So it will be ilayhi al-masir. Not written, but it's in my mind. So how would I pronounce it? Fattened or thin? That is the trick. What do we do?
Look at the letter before.
Look at the letter before. What is the letter before? Can we look at it? The letter before is yeah, but this is like the mad letter. So what do we need to go? Go further back. Another letter before, the sad. It has what? Kasra. It has kasra. Okay, so what? The letter before the ra, or the letter before the mad letter, which is before the ra, has kasra, then the ra will be thinned. Despite the fact that the ra has pesh or dhamma. Because now it will be inactive. So you will say, La ilaha illa huwa ilayhi al-masir. Look at the end of the ra. I'm sitting with shuyukh, of course, you guys know better. Huh? So I'm going to listen to it from you, inshallah, but after we take this call. As-salamu alaykum. Abdul Kareem from Kuwait. You see, Abdul Kareem versus Abdul Rahim. Abdul Kareem, as-salamu alaykum.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Abdul Kareem, welcome to the program. Can you recite from the beginning, please, of Surah Ghafir?
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Hameem. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم.
حسبك يا عبد الكريم بارك الله فيك. So in the same line as we were saying earlier concerning the fate of the pronunciation of the letter ra based on the vowel that appears on it, and in case that it is sukoon, which is original sukoon, or a sukoon that is temporary due to stopping on the letter ra. So give an example of the word al-masir. An original sukoon appears in the following ayah, in the word, particularly in the word yaghrurka, fala yaghrurka. Perfect. So look at the second ra, not the first ra. The second ra has sukoon, right? Our brothers from the Indo-Back ground, we call it jazm. Okay, that sukoon is original. It doesn't change due to any change that happens on the end of the word, or whether you stop, whether you connect it, فَلَا يَغْرُورْكَ تَقَلُّبُهُمْ or فَلَا يَغْرُورْكَ, and you stop. The sukoon is genuine. It is inseparable from the letter under any circumstances. So how would you pronounce it? Look at the previous letter. But the previous letter, ra, it doesn't matter. What concerns us, not the letter itself, what concerns us is the vowel on the letter. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived by having another ra before the ra, which is sakina. So look at it. فَلَا يَغْرُرْكَ. Why? The sakina ra is preceded by what? Don't you say by ra. I don't care whether it's ra or whatever.
by a pesh or dhamma. So that determines the ra should be fattened. Yeah. Right? Yeah. Heavy is not the right word. It's not heavy. It is
fat.
Yeah. Mufakham. Okay. The term is mufakham. While if it is thin, you call it muraqqaq, raqiq, such as, you know, the ayah number 6. Look at ayah number 6, the last word. And also I wanted to say something to Abdul Karim concerning the last word. وَكَذَلِكَ حَقَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّهُمْ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ. Ya Sheikh, he just said an-nar and you recited the ra' fattened, mufakhama. Yes, I did. But the ra' has a kasr. I don't care because when I stop at it, I change the kasra there into sukoon. So I should look at the vowel before. It's an alif. That is the mad letter. What is the one before? The noon. I don't care about the noon again. I care about the vowel, fatha, zabar. You know what? So why do some people say to the noon, ashabun nar? Who knows the reason? I'll tell you the reason. Normally the person mentally is prepared to read or to pronounce the following letter and to undergo any changes of fattening or thinning. So because ra will be fattened, so any thin letter may be sacrificed on the way. Be careful. Huh? The noon here is thin, very thin. How do you say it? Nancy. Okay? An-nar. An-nar. Okay? So the last comment is in ayah number 5 in the word liyudhidu, where many reciters will skip the letter da. Dad is not dal. Dal is thin, that's okay. Okay? Dal. But dad is a fat letter, and it is one of the letters of isti'la, one of the letters of tafkhim. Huh? Naam. So it must be given its due characteristics. So it is wrong to say liyudhidu. That sounds to me, I believe to you guys, as it is dal. While it is not, it is, it should be dad. Liyudhidu, liyudhidu. Tayyib, barakallah fiqh. Muhammad, would you please can begin?
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Hamim. Tanzilul Kitab min Allahil Azizil Alim.
Allah.
غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير ما يجادل في آيات الله إلا الذين كفروا فلا يغررك تقلبهم في البلاد كذبت قبلهم قوم نوح والأحزاب من بعدهم وهمت كل أمة برسولهم ليأخذوه وجادلوا بالباطل ليدحضوا به الحق فأخذتهم فكيف كان عقاب وكذلك حقت كلمة ربك على الذين كفروا أنهم أصحاب النار.
حسبك بارك الله فيك. نشواتي please continue.
الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم.
حسبك بارك الله فيك brother Nashawati. Just for the sake of time, we're going to take the last 1 minute or less than that with Muhammad Sharqawi. Please go ahead.
ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقيم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
حسبك محمد بارك الله فيكم. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us all our sins and guide us toward his best. May he keep us steadfast on his straight path. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. And until next week, I leave you all in the care of Allah. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslim's pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen.